All right, I am back in the locker room of Stamp Fairtex. Stamp, you made a valiant effort in defending your one Atomweight kickboxing world championship, but it did not go your way. Are you able to reflect right now and maybe see what you think didn't go right in the judges' minds?
สิ่งที่อะไรทำให้เราแพ้ในวันนี
้เราช้ากว่าเขาค่ะแล้วก็ออกอาวุธไม่ฉาชานมากกว่าเขาค่ะ
She think that from looking back she's maybe a little bit slower than her but she feels she have more powerful than her but you know but it didn't go her way so
Well it was a split decision it was really really close I'd like to ask you whatDo you think that focusing on mixed martial arts has taken away from, you know, a bit of your ability to really focus on your striking art? Or do you think that has nothing to do with it?
ถามว่าคิดไหมมีผลกระทบไหมที่คิดว่าจะเราอาจจะมุ่งมั่นกับ MMA มากไปแล้วก็ไม่ได้ฟิตหรือซ้อมกับคิกบ็อกซิ่งมากไป
ไม่มีผลกระทบค่ะเป็นตัวเราเองค่ะที่ไม่ออกอาวุธให้ดีกว่านี้ค่ะ
She said, no, it doesn't have effect on her. It justby herself, you know, that, you know, she didn't perform where she wanted to.
Okay, and lastly, do you anticipate that you, do you want to get a rematch? Do you want this, to get this back first, or are you going to continue to focus on, you know, mixed martial arts and your Muay Thai world title that you still own?
คิดว่าอยากจะไงนี่อยากจะกลับไปตั้งใจใน MMA หรือว่าอยากจะท้าชิงสักรอบหนึ่ง
อยากจะขอแก้มือค่ะอีกรอบหนึ่งค่ะเพราะว่าอยากเอาเข็มขัดกลับค่ะ
She won a rematch and then you know she won able to take the belt back this time
Okay well Stamp you did a great job tonight please don't hang your head too far you did amazing look forward to the rematch and I hope that you can learn a lot from this oneI have to start off by congratulating Janet Todd, the new one women's Atomweight kickboxing world champion. Tell me how that feels.
No words. I'm just really happy right now. I'm so thankful.
We were just talking about that, how it's hard to put to words the emotion when you finally become a world champion and realize a dream. I got to kind of see you before this, you know, talking to your husband and your friends mm-hmm. and your family. Maybe tell me a little bit about the support that you had going into this.
Man, I had so many messages from people on social media, you know, back home, my friends, my family. My husband actually compiled a video of all my friends saying a little bit of encouraging words and compiled it into a video. So I watched it before I left and I was just, man, I felt so encouraged and pumped up for this.
I could tell. And you came out on fire in that first round and you really didn't slow much, but you really had obviously a clear game plan. I think your hands looked excellent in that. I'd like you to maybe elaborate a little bit on what your game plan was coming into kickboxing. You know, it's a rematch of sort, but it's a different, you know, a different sport. You competed against Stamp in Muay Thai, but this is a kickboxing rule set. So how did you adjust?
So for this fight, obviously we can't use our elbows and we're not supposed to clinch. And I think I accidentally got into a clinch once or twice. but the game plan was to, you know, go to the legs, go to the body, and then switch it up to the head. So just switching directions, or not directions, switching levels, I guess.
Was aggression at all, like, something that you guys focused on in this?
Yeah, I wanted to pressure, but also if there was a stalemate where we were just standing in front of each other, I wanted to make sure that we reset so it's not like if I went, she'd counter right back, because that's what she's good at is mm-hmm. to counter back. So I wanted to give myself space if I needed to with my footwork.
And what were you thinking in that moment, you know, when it's, you know, red corner, blue corner, and it's coming down to a split decision. Obviously, another razor close match. You guys are such, gals, I should say, are such competitive athletes. You know, I think in that moment, I could only imagine what's going through your mind.
I think because it was a closed event, I could feel my heart beat. and I was like, and when Dom was like, and I was like, no. And when he said, I was like, oh my God, what just happened?
Well, I'll tell you what just happened. You just became a world champion for one championship, one of the biggest organizations to ever do this. So maybe talk a little bit about like what that means to you in closing.
like I said before, it literally means the world to me. You know, I've come close to getting gold before, and it just slipped away from my fingers. And then to have this moment to adjust and grow and be able to capture it, I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful for my team that got me here, that, you know, got me to improve as much as I did. So
I guess I said in closing, but I do want to ask you, if you just have a message now that you're the champion, you know, you're going to have a big target on your back. What do you think about that?
All champions do, but that's what we're, you know, everybody evolves. So obviously, if it was a close fight, there's probably going to be a rematch again. And I'm ready to, you know, fight against whoever they put in front of me. That's what a champion does, right?
It is. So you already are in the right mindset. Thanks for taking a second to talk to me. Please enjoy this victory. I know how much it means to you.
Thank you.